Hi, in this video I will do a really fast assembly of the Geeetech A30 FDM printer. I will go over specifications, compare it to competitors' new Creality CR10S PRO. I will reveal some bad things about it. By this I certainly cover most of the pre-assembled 3D printers, and towards the end I'll present the trailer about what's to come and how to kick this printer up a notch to make it perfect. The end will reveal what's Geeetech preparing for 2019. Welcome to my YouTube channel GreenEyedExplorer, where I explore further and beyond about tweaks, hacks, electronics and house repairs. Hi, first of all, I have to disclose the printer was fully paid by me and this is not a paid advertisement. What you will hear is solely my opinion. I have ordered it directly from Geeetech and it was delivered to me from their European warehouse. To summarize this video, it's the best large 3D printer of the 2018/19. In principle, all my statements are true on December 2018. Specifications. It's FDM, Fused Deposition Modeling Printer. The bed is one of the largest one could get. You can even print a size 12 shoe that is approximately European shoe size 46. It has two Z-axis, high resolution, print speeds are normal. It can print high temperature requiring filaments like ABS. It takes approximately 70 by 70 by 70 centimeters on the table. So, what's special about it? Two Z-axis spindles, it has a color LCD with touchscreen, automatic bed leveling, filament detector, resume after power outage, optional Wi-Fi printing and a pre-assembled printer kit. Comparison with Creality CR10S PRO. Well, both have two spindle, two motors, Z-axis. Similar temperatures, A30 has a higher resolution. For additional 10 bucks, both have auto bed leveling. One can print larger wheels. Stepper drivers do play a major role, but for additional 25 bucks, one can upgrade them. They are supported by A30. TMCs are way smoother and quieter. Trinamic TMCs are becoming a new gold standard. Teflon tube plays a role in extreme detailed prints. Both have touchscreen, power and filament detector, use 24-volt power supply. Meanwhile, is a recognized brand, but in the new age of capitalism this means it won't last longer. And Creality uses double-geared sprocket, which might play a role, but both printers lose in comparison to old-school geared extrusion. Geeetech Wifi module might work on Creality. So in conclusion, both are good, but A30 wins due to way lower price. Package and assembly. There are two main parts, the horizontal frame with the bed all pre-assembled and the vertical frame with the extruder. It comes with a manual which is very easy to follow and all the tools and even spare bolts and nuts one could wish for. There is even a nice mousepad as a gift. There are two brackets to join the horizontal and vertical frames. First, position the horizontal frame in front of you. The motor is in the back. Put vertical frame in the middle of it. The Z-axis motors are in the back and the extruder box is in the front. Use the T-bracket with the switch. Just slide it onto both joint frames on your left side. Tighten it slightly with the enclosed inbus key, not too tight. Put the other T-bracket on the other side and tighten it slightly as well. Now use large M5 screws and screw them through the bottom frame onto vertical frame. Two on each side. At the end, tighten both brackets. That's almost all. Now just check and connect the cables. They are well labeled and cannot be connected the wrong way. If it makes problems, see the manual. The bad and the ugly.
There are always some bad things sellers don't tell you about, so let's start. First of all, they have usual non-Austro-Hungarian quality control, if you remember the history. This means usual mass product quality. Here are some examples for my case. Here is one of the cables which was badly assembled, but this can be corrected. Many of the bolts were loose. I had to tighten them. Next, one of the roller wheels for the bed was loose. And in the end, there is a serious Y-axis offset problem in all of the A30 printers due to a missing part or firmware insufficiency. It took me exactly 30 seconds to find out where the problem is and how to solve it. Spoiler alert! This is the theme of another video. This problem shortens the print area by 3 cm in the Y-axis. Another problem, and a real one, is Geeetech's firmware. They call it Smarto. New A30 printers now include GTM42 Pro VB mainboard. Firmware is very buggy, but one can normally print. Here are some examples. The major problem is very odd Z-axis calibration. It is assisted, but before you figure it out, you end up with scraped superplate, which is a glass plate overheated bed, and it is covered with some sort of sticky material. Furthermore, I cannot calibrate touchscreen. Wi-Fi module does strange things when connected. If you try to calibrate the bed, it sends the printer head to the top. It is an open source printer, but code is written in IAR Workbench, which is very expensive, and their Eclipse version is not up to date, so it's useless. As I'm a programmer, I have checked the code. It's a state-of-the-art Ikebana with no consistency, but they are working on joining GTM 32 board sources with the latest Marlin release. And this should happen soon. Another thing I have encountered is a clumsy and hazardous wire organization in the mainboard box. Here you can see wires can melt as they touch heat sinks and the fans cannot operate normally as they are blocked. This falls under poor quality control.
Trailer.
Now it's time to invite you to watch my other videos about Geeetech A30 printers. In the second one, I will show you how to gain those 3 cm on Y-axis to make it a real 42x42 cm printer as advertised. In the third one, I will show you how to organize your mainboard printer box. We'll go through what's inside and how to tune the stepper drivers. We'll change them with Trinamic TMC 2208s. In the fourth one, I will explain how to level the bed, as this is the foremost problem with these printers. I'll show you how to mount the auto leveling probe and start using it. More videos will come if there will be interest, so you are invited to comment below what you would like me to talk about. I have years of 3D printing experience. You are also invited to share the video with your friends. As the research takes time and money, you can also buy me a coffee or even become my Patreon by submitting monthly payments.
The good and the summary.
One of the good things is good and dispersed customer support. They have multiple channels like homepage with a Q&A at the bottom, live chat on homepage, forum, Facebook group, GitHub and email support. Information about them is on their homepage. The most active ones are forum and Facebook group. Overall, it's the best cheap 3D printer one can get. It's best precise large 3D printer, best price, has all candies printer has to have, and the support is good. How to kick it up a notch? This is a short answer, as it already is a very good printer. Buy the induction probe for automatic leveling and buy Trinamic TMC 2208 stepper drivers. And what does Geeetech prepare for us in 2019? As you can see, the GTM 32 Pro board has one additional stepper driver slot. The answer lies in the smarter code. The information here is just my guess. They developed 2 different models of A30. The A30D will have two separate extruders, and the A30M model will have a mixing extruder like smaller M models like A20M. This is all. See you next time.